some people are doing while most of us are asleep.
Every night, while the city sleeps, thousands of people are doing one of the toughest jobs in the capital. It's a race against time, and by the morning, Londoners expect everything to be ready.
I don't always admit to people that I work for the Underground, because for some reason the general perception of the public that everybody that works on the Underground are idiots. And I used to think that about bus drivers before I joined the Underground. So I don't know why that is.
This is the last northbound overnight train from the station this evening.
A lot of the public think in my job I do nothing but stand about all the time. I get comments often like, why don't you get a proper job? All you ever do is stand around. What do you get paid for?
What they get paid for is keeping one of the oldest tube lines in London up and running.
Stand clear of the doors.
Nightmare journeys in 40-year-old trains turn the Northern Line into London's misery line. But now that's all changed, and the 51 stations, 36 miles of track and 84 new trains I kept moving day after day with constant maintenance.
All trains have now departed from the station. The station is closed.
But on the Underground, all this maintenance has to happen at night in just 4 hours.
And now all we've got to do is close the station.
Each night, after the last passengers have left London Bridge, up to 100 contractors invade the station to do anything from cleaning to bill posting, from track work to tiling, replacing everything from light bulbs to escalators. And every one of them has to get past Brian.
Well, as the governor of my pub says, there's only one person in charge around here, and that's me. And that's the way it is here. The supervisor's got to be in charge. Someone has to take responsibility, and in this case, it's me, London Bridge supervisor. Can I have your passes, please? Yes, please. There's quite a lot of sewage-type water coming in. I'm a nurse, a police officer. Oh, well, you can't. I'm the whole thing. If you give me my pass, no. Every year we have a huge exam. I mean, I don't think even doctors do that. Do you need any keys? Yes, sir. Don't be silly now. I'm like those mice you saw running around on the platform. I don't stop. I keep moving.
Sure.
And there's no passengers.
Find it horrendous working nights?
Not working the nights themselves. Keep changing shifts is what I find horrendous. It's very difficult to get your sleep patterns back. Your eating patterns go up the wall. I don't have a love life now. That's gone. That's all finished. Ever since I started on the Underground.
With the current off, a maintenance team can now get on the tracks between Mornington Crescent and Euston. Groundwater constantly leaks into the tunnels and erodes the wooden sleepers under the rail. So for the last month, the team has been digging out all the rotten timber. But so far, they've only got 60 metres down the tunnel from Euston. Tonight, they're hoping to replace two more sleepers in time for the first train at 5:30 a.m.
I've been doing the job 11 years.
I get job satisfaction of seeing what I've done in the night. And there's so much riding on what we do. You've got so many millions of passengers running on the underground every day. And if we make a mistake, then, you know, it could be an accident or, you know, a disaster of some degree. You know, so it's definitely a demanding job.
I enjoy working at night because I know I can get on with doing things. It can be a race against time because not only have I got to get on with my jobs, there's the contractors that can be in the way, and obviously the cleaners have got to clean the station.
At night, Tony's tasks range from the vital to the routine. Everything from testing ticket machines to locating lost property. From organising staff rotors to checking the fire alarms.
Do you ever get lonely down here?
No, never get lonely. There's too many people about on the station to get lonely. There's always the mice. They're all friendly little characters. And in summer we get mosquitoes. I don't know what variety they are, but I've been bitten about three times. I don't think they're poisonous or anything like that. We don't have cats or rats or anything like that. Maybe the odd stray dog. It manages to catch the train on its by itself somewhere. And in the end, if we can't catch them, we have to call the RSPCA.
At the end of the line in Morden, the last train is pulling in for the night. But the daily grind doesn't stop here. Here, 40 trains get their nightly makeover. Each of them travels over 300 miles a day. And this punishment means that everything from wheels to wiring, brakes to seat covers, and windows to windscreen wipers has to be repaired. And they've only got 3.5 hours to get it done.
Everything that happens on the train, we have to repair it in one way or another, because the crew can refuse to take the train if the fault is still there the next day. So that's why it's more hectic, if you like, on nights.
It's not easy to work in the night. See, around 1-2 o'clock, you feel like going to bed, you know, but you have to cope. See, it's not easy.
Are you proud of the work you do?
Yes, very proud of it. Very, very proud of it. Especially the Northern Line. It's very nice, clean trains.
Hello, it's Brian, London Bridge supervisor. I've got a company by the name of Aqua End to do grouting on 13, escalator 13, but they're not on the works plan.
Brian has to check with his boss to see if a team of engineers can get onto one of the escalators tonight.
Okay. That looks like a no-no. You're not on the works plan. We don't know anything about it. So, as he said, if there was just a survey, I'd let you do it. But you're not going to work tonight, and you're certainly not going to put a scaffold up.
What's your name?
What's my name?
Yeah.
Brian.
Brian, okay. Is he looking into it?
I believe so.
All right. Do you want to check with him?
No. Okay, I'll give him another ring, and if he's happy with it, I'll let you in. If he's not, then you obviously won't come in.
come the morning, you would think you were tired and not ready to deal with people again. But funnily enough, you are.
I don't know who designed these, but by shooting.
I suppose in the back of your mind, you know that within a couple of hours, that's going to be the end of your working day, where theirs is just beginning. Which gives me just a pleasure thinking about
it. Yeah. All right, fine. Cheers. Right, he's happy to let you work, so on that basis, so am I.
Right.
So I should tell you now, if I see you about on an escalator, you'll be out, the lot of you.
That's why
okay?
I'm here.
Because it's my responsibility to maintain the assets.
That's why I'm here.
All right, mate?
To check that they do it
and
properly.
Bearing in mind you're not even on the works plan.
Thanks for that.
Bye.
You feeling stressed now, right?
Not really, no.
No?
No.
Things just starting to get excited.
Yes.
London Bridge has had a space-age refit, but the staff around the station don't seem to have changed.
There's not many women around, are there? It's a very male atmosphere. Do you notice that?
No, not now. Yes, it was. There was very few women. There certainly wasn't any train staff. There's a few more now. But you may have noticed tonight that actually there was a few women signed in tonight, and that they're getting more and more and more. They're becoming engineers and, you know, they're not just making the tea. They are bona fide, qualified people. So it is changing.
For the better?
Well, I don't suppose they can do any worse job than the people we've got at the moment. Yeah, so yeah, they're doing, they're pulling their weight,
Back at the depot, the trains are getting their monthly washdown.
I don't think passengers realise what we have to do to keep the trains running. They just don't seem to realise the mess that they make. Like kids at the north end of the line, breaking windows with catapults or air guns, running out of the bushes when the train stables in a platform, and graffiti in the side of the train.
At the moment, the worst problem we have here is the chewing gum on the floor, graffiti on the train, which, I mean, it's giving a headache. So like this one, there's nothing we can do about it. We have to remove the whole door. That I can't just understand it, you know? I can't just understand why people just get on the train, they start writing things, silly things, sorry to say, silly things, using the F word and all that, you know? Which is very bad.
People are particularly badly behaved on the tube. For some reason, they seem to think they can come down here and do as they like. Use it as a toilet. Abuse the staff.
People spitting annoys me because it spreads disease, and I don't think they realise that.
Would be nice if we didn't have passengers, I suppose. I suppose I shouldn't say that, but...
The job of keeping the tracks safe depends on a few lone men.
Every night I just start at Camden Town and I walk to Waterloo. It's about 5 kilometres. Just checking out faults in the track, like broken rails or any loose fastenings, bolts. I've been doing it for about 12 years now. It's 2:45, it's pretty late, and I've got another 6 or 7 stations to walk, which is quite a distance. But obviously I'll have to get to that destination before 5 o'clock, which I have to be off the track, so they can switch on the power for the first train to run on time. My mates and my family can't believe I work nights. They just think I'm abnormal. I've got no social life at all, you know? It's lonely. It's a job's a job.